Good morning, everyone. Good morning. Grabe. Actually, pasensya na sa background, no? Pasensya na sa quality ng video and everything. Actually, mayroon po talaga akong ginawang video nung kaya kagabi, hanggang madaling araw, and then I try uploading it. However, may problem po, ayaw mag-upload. Yung cellphone, kasi sa cellphone ko lang po siya ginawa ngayon. I'm recording this using another gadget, and hopefully, ma-upload ito mamaya na maayos. So, good morning po, no? Ayan, I really miss you guys. I miss the church. Ako makikita sa PowerPoint ngayon na sinishare. Ayan, kung nandiyan ka, kaway-kaway ka sa camera. Kaway-kaway ka. Comment down below if you miss the church. No? Lagay mo na lang, I miss everyone para safe. Huwag mo na ilagay kung sino yung namimiss mo na sa church. Pero anyway, so how are you doing, guys, ngayong umaga? Ako medyo stressful kasi nga yung technicalities, ang hirap. I'm just really praying na sana maging ano to, maging maayos na, ma-upload na maayos. And actually, natutuwa din ako kasi in a way, sabi ko nga, Lord, baka talagang sinahayaan mo to para baka talagang ma-experience ko yung message for today. Ay, naka church, pray with us na in this trying times. While I was asking the Lord kung ano siya ngayong araw. No, he led me to in a verse in Romans chapter 8 verse 5. Sinabi doon, the mind governed by the flesh is death, but the mind governed by the spirit is peace and life, or life and peace. Church, let's pray first before we even proceed sa ating message for today. Father, we thank you for this day you've given us. Lord, maraming nangyayaring abiriya. Hindi namin inaasahan, but you are still God. And I believe, Lord, that you will fulfill your purpose in everything that's been happening, Lord. I'm just praying na protektahan mo kami sa ginagawa ngayon ng kalaban in the midst of our ministry, of this live service. Be with us, O Father. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Ayan. So, just want to ask, Church, we have already exceeded all 1 year, or yung nga, exceeded na ngayon 1 year through this pandemic, and I want to ask everyone, no? I want to ask you, ikaw, nanonood ngayon, how's your mental health? Ayan. Now, so para lang sa, madalas natin marinig to lalo na ngayon pandemic, di ba, yung mental health. Pero ano nga ba talaga mental health? In layman's term lang butong binigay ko. Now, our mental health is our ability to cope up with normal stresses in life to function well. Now, basically, it's something that all of us have para maging maayos tayo. Kumbaga, this is what keeping us, keeping our sanity. Na parang kung ikaw okay physical, parang physical health lang din po yung mapatid. If you are okay physically, you will able to do things physically na maayos, ha? Para makakagawa ka ng sport, makagalaw-galaw ka na maayos, yun yung physical health. The same with sa mental health, no? Ito rin yung ability natin na para tayo ay to keep our sanity clear. Now, disclaimer lang po, no? We are not going to have a professional diagnosis regarding your mental condition or whatsoever. Actually, kaya ko lang po, wala lang ako nalid ng Panginoon din dito sa message ito because we have this webinar regarding this as well. And may mga nakuha ko doon, sabi ko, oh nga, no, it's time. And I think that the Lord is leading us to talk about such things. And kahit na hindi tayo tawag dito expert when it comes to this, now we can all agree that one way or the other, we are all having some difficulty with our mental health, especially in these times. Tama po ba? Maybe you are experiencing stress, helplessness, worthlessness, high irritability, easily angered, and emotional exhaustion, negative attitude, nung saan nagiging suspicious ka na. Diba? Sino sa inyo yung mga... Although, before pa naman ng pandemic, probably naranasan mo na to. No? Pero somehow, ngayon pandemic, lalo na siyang grumabe, no? Na nadadagdagan. And then, masama dito, yung nga, nagiging suspicious ka na. Mga tipong, diba? May vaccine. Okay kaya yan. Mga kapatid, we prayed for it, no? A year ago, and ngayon na may vaccine na, I think we we need to step out in faith. And anyway, alam niyo po yun. Trust God. And I believe as well that doctors, researchers, gift yan sa Panginoon eh. Diba? And kung talaga may, ano, I mean, kung talagang hindi para sa yung vaccine, well, pag tinurok sa'yo yan, wala effect yan. That's how God will protect us in many ways, I believe. Kaya, pero probably, of course, in because of what's happening around us, baka nagiging ganyan ka na, nagsuspicious ka na sa mga bagay-bagay na nga sa paligid mo. Or probably, and it's leading us to experiencing apathy, yung wala ka ng pakialam, no? Nagkakaroon ka na, nagiging indifferent ka na sa mga bagay-bagay sa paligid mo, and nagiging frustrated ka na. Ayan, lalo na po may mga plano na hindi na nagiging maayos. Diba? Katulad ngayong umaga. Nagiging frustrated na ako mga kapatid kung alam nyo lang. Kasi ngayon yung video, hindi ma-upload na maayos na. Anyway, the Lord knows why. And sabi ko, Lord, bakit kaya? But I'm just praying na sana. Whew, makayanin natin ito mentally, na? And then, it's leading, of course, after being frustrated in many things, it's slowly being led into depression, and then being unexcited about life. Kung tawag lang, ano, dysthymia. No, it, ang ano nito po, yung ano, ang kanyang pinaka-layman's term, parang since every day, yun na lang at yun na lang din ang nangyayari, nawawala ka na ng gana. No? Na nawawala ka na ba ng gana, bumangon sa umaga, and then as a minister, nagkakaroon ang tinatawag na compassion fatigue. Yan. Now, scientifically speaking, these are the terms that are really existing na kung saan, mga kapatid, honestly, hindi ko kayang explain. However, the Bible is also teaching us the same thing. Yun nga lang on the spiritual side of our mental condition. It was mentioned in Romans. Binalikan natin kanina in chapter 8 verse 5 that the mind that our minds can be controlled or governed either by flesh or by spirit. Sabihin, dalawa lang pong entity ang pwede mag ang nagkocontrol ng mind mo, kaya mo nararanasan yan is either the flesh or the spirit. And the idea here, mga kapatid, is that there is a constant battle of good and evil inside our minds. Na parang itong picture na ito. And somehow, what I love about the Word of God is that it already gave us, actually, mga kapatid, the key in winning this battle. Ayan. And what better way to do it than understanding how we are being attacked in the flesh? No, how we are being governed by the enemy in the flesh, and later on being equipped as we go through this battle in our minds. Now, let's read our story for today from the Bible through the life of our Lord Jesus, because even him, no, he was not exempted to this battle, mga kapatid. During his time here on earth, he is also he also underwent this battle, and we will see here how the enemy had been attacking our minds back then up to now. In Matthew chapter 4, verses 1 to 11, probably alam niyo na po yung story na yan, mga kapatid, di ba? It talks about Jesus Christ or being tempted by the enemy. And sinabi ho dyan in verse 1 and verse 2, then Jesus was led by the Spirit into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil. After fasting 40 days and 40 nights, he was hungry. Now, before we even move forward with the message, the first thing we need to understand and embrace is that as a human beings, we have limitations. I don't know why, but that phrase of saying he was hungry, it really get into my head. Sabi ko, ano? I think one of the things that we need to realize, mga kapatid, nowadays is that we have limitations and mental health is real. You and I have this and we need to be aware of it. I like, sabi ko nga kanina, how the author place that phrase that he was hungry. I guess it's just to say that although our Lord Jesus is fully God at that time, he is also fully human, okay, who has limitations. And the thing is, we will not be able to move forward with our healing, not unless we accept our situation. One thing I would like for us to be aware of, mga kapatid, in this message is that hindi lang nag-iinarte o OA ang isang tao when he or she is going through these kind of things. I admit that I used to think that way. However, after a year of this pandemic and observing things around us, we can see that this is something to be taken seriously. Kapatid, if you're watching this, I want you to know that you don't need to act strong and mighty all the time. Accepting that we have limitations would help us to prepare that we need to take care of our mental health as we are taking care of our physical health. Sabi nga, the most courageous act of self-care is I need help. Mga patid, I need help. Na? So sabi mo sa sarili mo yan, I need help. I need help. Now, going dito, moving forward sa story, so after na sinabi din na he was hungry, now there's an intense battle na nangyari ngayon between the enemy and Jesus Christ. The greatest mind game begin. Yan. So magkaroon sila ng conversation. And Satan tried to tempt Jesus Christ not once, not twice, but three times. Na sinabi niya sa kanya una, sabi, if you are the Son of God, tell these stones to become bread. Obvious nga naman because he was hungry. But somehow, Jesus Christ answered, man shall not live on bread alone, but on every word that comes from the mouth of God. E mga kapatid, kung hindi mo alam, that's a verse that can be found in Deuteronomy. No? So gumamit si Jesus ng salita ng Diyos ng sa nasa scriptures to answer back sa Satan. And then after this first attack, of course, nagkaroon na naman ng pangalawang attack, ang kalaban, may nag-rebattle. Basta ganon. Rebat, nag-rebat. No? Sabi ni Satan, if you are the Son of God, throw yourself down for it is written, he will command his angels to save you. Sorry. So, gumamit pa ng verse si Satan. Diba? Sabi, it is written. Sinabi din na Panginoon, so, sumagot din siya ng verse, it is also written that you shall not put the Lord your God to the test. Wow. Grabe si Lord, di ba? Ang lupit. May rebuttal din. And then, sumagot ulit si Satan, na ba, hindi pa natuto. Napahiya ka na una, pangalawa, hindi ka pa natuto. Ha? Sinabi ni Satan na, all this I will give you. What happened in here, mga kapatid, is that Satan took Jesus Christ in a very high place, kung saan he can see all the wonders of the kingdoms of the earth. Okay? And then sinabi ng Panginoon ni Satan, all this I will give you if you will fall down and worship me. Wow. Tempting, hindi ba? Sinabi ng Panginoong Jesus, you shall worship the Lord your God and Him only shall you serve. So imagine mo, no, si Jesus Christ, pinakita siya ng masarap na pagkain, giving him the assurance na if you're powerful, sige, gawin mo nga to. Parang tawag dito, pinoprovoke. No? And then he even shown Jesus Christ na yung mga lahat mga gandang bagay sa mundo. And sabi niya na, I will give this to you. Just worship me. Napakasimple lang naman eh. Hindi ba? And this intense exchange of words, now I believe this is a scenario that explains how the enemy is governing us through our flesh. And the thing here, church, is that if we don't take good care of our mental health, or if we don't take good care of our minds, is an opportunity for the enemy to attack. We need to understand that some or most of our mental stressors in life are caused by the enemy. Remember that the enemy only has three sole purpose, and that is to kill, steal and destroy. In John 10:10, the thief comes only to steal, kill and destroy. Now, but the thing is, church, Satan cannot read our minds. The enemy cannot read our minds, but he can influence our thoughts. So we need to realize it and be aware of that scenario, mga kapatid. And after knowing that we have limitations, yung internal factor, we need also to be aware of the external factors. Ito nga yung attack ni Satan, coming from the outside, giving us influences, showing us mind games that is attacking and governing us in our flesh. And like we already saw in the story of Jesus Christ, he is attacking this same way over and over again. No, madalas itong ginagamit niya yung lust of the body, lust of the eyes, and then the pride of life. Now, I'm not going to go in details to that. Kasi ang mahalaga lang naman na malaman natin, maintindihan natin mga kapatid, that the enemy is at work in our minds. Lalo lang siyang nabigyan ng opportunity this pandemic. Okay? So ano yung purpose ko bakit sinishare ito mga kapatid? Is that so you and I would understand that most of the time, although yes, meron din tayong mga ginagawang, o meron din mga reason kung bakit tayo nagkakagrito na tayo ang may kasalanan. However, I want you to know na it's not just because of you. So don't be hard on yourself. Baka mamaya nagagalit ka sa maling rason, baka nagagalit ka sa sarili mo because of this, because of that, kaya nas lalo ka na i-stress mentally. However, I want you to know, kapatid, that the enemy has been influencing us with lies, deceit, and doubt. And don't worry, no? Huwag kang mag-alala, huwag kang mag-alala, kapatid. Because in spite of this attack ng enemy, mga kapatid, I want you to know that we are powerful than the enemy. Don't worry, there is hope. With the help of our Lord, we can do something about it. Sinabi nga ng 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 13. Therefore, prepare your minds for action. We may prepare. Discipline yourselves. Set all your hope on the grace that Jesus Christ will bring you when He is revealed. With the help of our Lord, mga kapatid, we can do something about it. We can prepare our minds just like how our Lord Jesus was able to win over this battle with the enemy. And that's a hope that I want you guys to embrace today. Meron kang pwedeng gawin, kapatid, para mapangalagaan mo ang iyong mental health. Now that we diagnose the internal and the external factors of our mental stressors in life, the only question left to be answered is, how can we win? Anong dapat natin gawin? And I want you to take note of this because this would be very important for in our lives, mga kapatid. For us to be able to win this battle in our minds na binibigyan ng kaaway sa atin, we need to develop a good mental and spiritual hygiene. Ayan. Now, bigyan ko na ng konting definition. No? Mental hygiene is the science of maintaining mental health and preventing the development of psychosis, neurosis, or other mental disorders. So basically, mental hygiene ay parang ano, kung paano mo inaalagaan yung katawan mo, di ba? Meron din mga paraan kung paano mo aalagaan yung pag-iisip. Okay? And the spiritual side of it, of course, maraming mga, mamaya, badaaran din natin yung mga scientific, tawag dito, suggestions ng mga professionals about it. Pero in the spiritual side, na mahalaga to mga kapatid, is that for us to be able to have our to develop a good spiritual and mental hygiene is that actually sila naman talaga meron mga kapatid. Ano yun? We need to be rooted in the Word of God. Now, how would you be rooted in the Word of God? There's just three things I want to share to you guys. Mabiging mabilis lang to. Okay, kasi napaka-basic naman talaga nito eh. Kailangan lang application eh. Being rooted in the Word of God, it means first memorizing God's Word. Now, we all know Jesus didn't use any other weapon or tool to fight the enemy than the Word of God. As Pop used to say to us, the Holy Spirit's role is to counsel us in during these times in our mental battles. Now, the Spirit will remind us of these verses that we read and memorize. However, the Spirit can only remind us of what we know already. Ang example nga lagi dito ni Pop, and I really like this example, yung exam. Pag nag-exam ka, you pray na makapasa ka ng exam, the Lord will help you out. That's true. However, hindi sa iyo ibibigay ng Panginoon yung hindi mo alam, yung hindi mo na-review. Okay? ang gagawin niya, he will help you to, ano mo yun, remember yung mga bagay na na-review mo. Pero hindi pwede sa'yo ibigay yung sagot. Cheating po yung mga kapatid. That would be cheating. Di ba? Dito papasok, kapatid, yung araw-araw at gabi-gabi na magbabasa ng Biblia. Katulad yan ang sinabi ng Psalms chapter 1 verses 2 and 3. But they delight in the law of the Lord, meditating on it day and night. They are like trees planted along the riverbank, bearing fruit each season. Their leaves never wither, and they prosper in all they do. So kung nahihirapan ka mga batid na, no, na gawin yan, may mga suggestions na science no, para to be able to cope up with mental health, kasama din dyan yung titawag, kailangan mo mag-journals, do journals, develop and follow a routine or plan ahead. Kung nahihirapan ka na, ano, na hindi kasi ako morning person, hindi ako night person eh. One thing na kailangan mong gawin kapatid o pwede mong umpisahan, set an intentional time. Do journals, plan ahead. Even the science says na it could help you out to release yung mga gusto mong sabihin, gusto mong express, you can do it in a journal. And that is actually helpful in our mental health. Now, of course, memorizing is one thing, pero yung pangalawa, mahalaga din to mga kapatid. Getting rooted in the Word of God is more than just memorizing it, but also trusting and believing the power of the Word of God. As I've said earlier, memorizing is one thing, but convincing yourself to trust and believe is another. Katulad ng sinabi ng Jeremiah chapter 17 verses 7 and 8, the scripture says, "But blessed is the one who trusts in the Lord, whose confidence is in Him. They will be like a tree planted by the water that sends out its roots by the stream. It does not fear when the heat comes. Its leaves are always green. It has no worries in a year of drought and never fails to bear fruit." Ayan ang kagandahan kapag tayo ay rooted sa salita ng Panginoon. In the story of Jesus, in this scripture, he doesn't only memorize the scripture, but he knows what it meant and how powerful it is. Remember, mga kapatid, that God gave us the authority to rule over our minds. As it said in the book of Romans, chapter 12, verse 2. Gusto ko yung version nito, sabi doon, "Don't copy the behavior and the customs of this world, but let God transform you into a new person by changing the way you think." The thing is, when we trust and believe the power of God's word, we are engaging ourselves to positivity. Okay, positivity. And when we start to engage in positivity and trusting the word of God, the more natin na-embrace yung phrases like God is good. God loves me. God loves you. God is sovereign. God is a great provider. God knows my pain. Yan yung mga positivity in life eh. That the moment we trust and believe in the word of God, these are the things mga kapatid na that our hearts and our minds will dwell in, and mas magiging okay ka. The moment we start practicing filling ourselves with positivity, we'll be able to experience peace, joy, trust, and a stronger faith. We'll start to be contented, happy, and grateful. We'll start to add some humor in our life. We were able to laugh more. Diba, hindi ka nega. And alam nyo ba, mga kapatid, in science, embracing positivity plays a big role in developing self-care management. Sinabi nga nila dyan sa science, in self-care management, you can reflect and reevaluate your purpose, finding balance in life, work, family, and personal life. And sa katulad ng mga nakaraan natin message, di ba? Exercise, get enough sleep, even finding a pet can be also a way of coping up with your mental health. Mag-alaga ka po ng ano ng isang domestic na hayop, no? Huwag yung mga inaalagaan ni Shin. Nakakatakot eh. No? And of course, kasama din sa self-care management is strengthening family bond. Eat together, watch a movie, divide and share house chores. Ayan, in a very positive manner. Na hindi stressful ma. Baka lalo lang nagdagan yung mental stressors mo ha. And then Isa rin sa mahalaga tayo ng self-care management is turning off and tuning in. Turning off your distractions, tuning in to your loved ones, ending media mania. Yan, magbawas-bawas ka ng social, ayan, social media. Unplug and detox. E kung mapapansin nyo mga patid, even this self-care management that science is suggesting us to do, we can find this in the Bible. Re-evaluating mo yung purpose mo, that is your calling. Diba? Strengthening family bond, the Bible is clear about making time with your family. Kung paano ko dapat maging isang asawa, isang anak. So, you can see there's really a beautiful bond between science and the religion and divinity. So, di nyo pwedeng paghiwalayin talaga sila mga patid. Na, it's just really about how you're going to take it in your perspective. Okay? And so ito yung mga mahalagang bagay na kailangan nating gawin is to fill ourselves with this positivity for us to be able to cope up in our mental health. And last but not the least, to get rooted in the Word of God, we need to seek help. Now, medyo, parang, seek help, parang nangyari, parang masabi seeking help. Is Jesus Christ, meron ba siyang sinik na help, tingin ninyo, in this part of the story? Sa so story, dito may kita. Okay? Pero, what we can see in the life of our Lord Jesus, even after this, isang character niya na hindi natin tawag dito, hindi natin mamimiss na mapansin, is that in every situation, He always seek help to His Father. Amen? He would go to a quiet place to pray, to ask God, to seek help. Even when he tried to resurrect Lazarus, diba? He prayed to Father to seek help. He always seek help. Lalo-lalo na mga panahon na yan because wala pa siya ibang kasama kundi siya lang at ang Diyos, of course, in what they are, in what he is going through. And of course, tayo, ay meron din tayong ganyan pong, meron po tayong karapatan or privilege pala, karapatan, privilege to seek God help in our needs. No? However, meron din pong pinakamagandang way din bukod sa seeking God for help, dito rin po papasok, mga kapatid, yung seeking help to people around us. And dito po papasok ngayon yung church. A new study has found that regular attendance at religious services offers significant protection against depression. Ayan, mga kapatid, ha? If you're feeling depressed, manood ka na service. True, science says na it plays a significant protection against depression. Sabi nga ng 1 Thessalonians chapter 5 verse 11, encourage one another and build each other up. That is the purpose of the church, mga patid. Kaya kung ikaw ay nakaka-feel ka ng depression, anxiety, worry, watch a live service. Maganda nga sa panahon ngayon, naka-record na lahat, eh, pwede mong balik-balikan na yung mga messages. Now, gusto ko lang ding i-clear out na mga patid, none of us are experts or have already mastered fighting mental issues or keeping our mental health steady. That somehow that's one of the reason why we need each other. Probably some of us would say na, hindi, Kuya Bert, mayroon talaga akong sakit ng depression and anxiety. Ito na sinabi mo kanina, ba, clinically, depression is real. If that's the case, church, if that's the case, kapatid, I encourage you to seek professional help. And kapag sinabi ko professional help, you would really go to a doctor na license about this para magkaroon ka ng magandang diagnosis. Diba? May mga guidance counselors dyan, psychologists, psychiatrists, physicians, and mental health advocates. Don't hesitate to go to the doctor para at least malaman mo din na if you are really going through a clinical depression. Because ito na mga yung mga batid na kailangan natin itindihin din. Embracing mental disorders is true. Pero minsan ang nagiging mali is that nag-assume lang tayo. Nakita mo lang sa Google, nakita mo lang sa Facebook na ito yung mga classifications ng depression, anxiety. Inisip mo agad, depressed ako. Well, kung if you really feel that, I advise you seek professional help. Now, kung talagang hindi mo kaya, wala kang budget. Actually, may mga LGUs, NGOs na ngayon na nag-offer na cheaper price for this. Lalo na sa mga panahon ngayon ng ating mental health ay talaga namang naapektuhan. And you can go to ano to websites, no? Ay, meron po yan mga kapatid. Okay, itry nyo doon sa member natin na ano, social worker. Si Rema, alam ko meron silang mga alam na ganyan. Or, dito ngayon papasok mga kapatid yung ating simbahan, yung ating samahan, yung ating church. Pastors, leaders, ate and kuya in the ministry, we have a big responsibility. You have a big responsibility of helping people around us, keeping our mental health stable, especially during this time. But somehow the challenge here is that if you're watching this today, bago ka lang dito or hindi ka pa ganong tawag dito, di mo pa ganong alam kung nasaan ka ngayon when it comes to your faith in God, I'm encouraging you to be open. The church is open for you. Our lines are open for you. Now, let's remember mga kapatid that taking good care of our mind is important. It's a mandate for us to take. Kaya nga, ang title ng message natin ngayong umaga ay Mindatory. Take care of your mental health. Be closer sa Panginoon. Get rooted in His Word and seek help to people around you. We are here for you, kapatid. Let's survive this together. Okay, Ben? Please join me in faith and let's pray. Panginoon, maraming salamat sa umagang ito. Lord, even though maraming mga bagay na hindi naging maayos at things didn't go plan really well, I'm praying, Lord, na and I believe na ito yung purpose mo. And I'm praying, O Father, na ikaw lamang yung patuloy namin na maitaas, mapapurihan as we continue living our life, letting your spirit to govern our minds. Lord, help us to get rooted in your word. Help us, Panginoon, speak to us, open our ears and our hearts to your word. We surrender everything sa iyo, Panginoon, and protect us from the works of the enemy. Use our lives for the glory of your name. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen and amen. God bless, church. God bless.